Hello, good morning everyone. My name is Anand Vardhan and this time I've scored All India Rank 7 in Civil Services Examination. So to begin with, I'll just like to say, I'll just talk a bit about myself. This was my fourth attempt at the examination. I passed out as a mechanical engineer in 2013. And since then, I've taken four attempts, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So initially, for the first three attempts, I had public administration as my optional. So I was not able to do very well with that. My strategy in that optional was not good, was not great. So I always ended up scoring less marks. The maximum I scored in three attempts was 206. So this time around, I changed my optional to political science, which had some sort of overlap with public administration and also with GS. So so with that, I would like to tell you about the whole preparation strategy, how the journey has been, what are the few major aspects that need to keep in mind. And as sir mentioned, I was a student of 100 current affairs class here. In this very classroom, I used to come and attend those classes before my 2015 mains examination. So in my four attempts, the first two attempts, I cleared the prelims. I reached the mains exam. In my third attempt, in which I took the classes here and did some answer writing, I cleared the mains. I reached the interview. And finally, this time, in my fourth attempt, I have gotten a rank. So I'll just like to begin with a few core aspects of the exam and how to build around your preparation. So first of all, I'd just like to know how many of you still have to take your first attempt or took your first attempt this time? Okay, quite a few, but most of you have taken a few attempts at the exam. So the point is that those of you who have already taken attempts would be aware about the book list and the syllabus that is there for the exam. And all of us know ki ye particular books hain, these are the things that you need to know. So ultimately, I think the number one aspect I'd like to talk about is revision, because that is one of the prime things that is going to get you in the game and keep you in the game. Because sometimes it's very easy to lose track, because syllabus itna bada hai, it is so vast. So it is very easy to lose track of things. And just if you have read something once, trust me, you'll not be able to recollect it. Even if you're able to recollect parts of it, you'll not be able to reproduce it. So there are two or three parts to your memory where you have to focus on. First of all, you have to get it. So for in my case, for example, typically three revisions were needed before I could reproduce the whole thing in the examination. So revision is one of the key aspects of the examination. And you need to plan your revisions accordingly. So for example, if you read something today, then probably you should go back to it a week later, not later than that. So at least go back to it a week later, so that at least 60% of it is already in your memory, and the rest of it gets revised again. Apart from that, I think that one aspect of the exam is choosing the sources and believing that these sources are enough. So what happens is in this preparation, there's so much material in the market that you know, you tend to accumulate a lot of things and you're not able to revise that. So I would just like to say that keep two things in mind. The requirement of the exam is that you write answers in the examination. So the number one requirement is that whatever you are reading, whether it be a Yojana article or a Hindu article, just look at it from that angle ki isko main jab answer mein reproduce karunga, to what can I use, what can I write from here? And sometimes the answer will come that this article is rather useless. You'll not be able to write this in your answers, right? So that filtering has to happen at that level also, ki what is useful, matlab, you have to channel all of your effort into that direction where you can produce a good answer. And the second aspect is the sources, as I said, you know, that limiting your sources. So for current affairs, for example, there's so much online material, PDFs are available, monthly supplements are available. But for example, for mains in 2015 and 16 both, I have referred, apart from one or two monthly supplements, I have referred to these ED booklets for my mains examination. And this time around, since I changed my optional, I didn't have much time for GS. I devoted a lot of time to Pol Science, since it was a new subject for me. So for the mains, for the GS 2 and 3 especially, you really, really have to have a grip on the current affairs. Because what happens is at least 10 to 12 questions are from contemporary developments or current happenings. So unless you have a grip on that, unless you explore a few aspects of it in your answer, you'll never be able to write a great answer. Your answer can be good, but again, good might not be enough because everyone, almost everyone writes a good answer. So the point is that how to approach the current affairs and how to narrow down the sources which you have. So as sir mentioned, there are two aspects to it. One of them is the ED class which runs here. So every Sunday you have an editorial discussion for the past 1 week. But the point with that is that if you have a booklet each week, so about 6 months into your preparation, you will have 20-25 booklets, right? And for one whole year, you will have about 50 booklets. But I don't think that is the way it runs here. So there's also that 100 current affairs for mains, which I joined in 2015. So what they do is that all of the topics which have come in the news for the entire year, they summarize the important ones and club, because some of the topics get repeated. So they club all of that information into one topic. And then you probably have 10 to 15 booklets into which the entire year's worth of current affairs is there. So usko refer karna and believing that it is enough. So in my 16 attempt, 15 mein I had already done the 100 current affairs class. So in my 16 attempt, I revised that, number one. And number two, I did 2016 wala booklets. So in 2016, I did not attend a class. So the point of self-study, which sir was mentioning, is that, again, you've got to have belief that this is enough. So most of us are not able to believe that or think that there's a necessity of doing a class. So once I knew that these booklets were useful and I had done the class in 15, so I just picked them up from the market and I revised them. I self-studied them at least twice or thrice so that the whole thing sets into your head and then you are able to reproduce in the exam. Apart from that, I would say that there are a few aspects of the exam which keep changing over time. So for example, this time in GS, you would have seen in the mains, if you have seen the papers, that there were a few obscure questions which nobody could attempt, and then there is always open-ended questions where you don't exactly know what is being asked or what could be written. So I think those questions are the most important. And again, in polity, in GS2 last year, there was a lot of static portion also. For example, there was a question on a preamble and what are the adjectives with the republic and everything, and you have to explain each one of them. So you have to balance both static and current prep. And again, UPSC has this tendency that it gives you a certain way of asking questions in 1 year, and then you believe that probably next year it will be carried forward. So for example, last year prelims mein, there was a lot of current affairs, right? And mains, then the whole thing, there was also a static portion. But this time in prelims, if you have seen the paper, it was entirely different ball game. It was not the same thing as last year. So please understand that if you have a fixed strategy, if you're not flexible, it will cost you. And if you're leaving out certain portions for the exam, for example, last year my prep was good because I had been following current affairs for my interview. I had reached the interview stage, and when I took the prelims, I was already aware of a lot of current affairs, and that saved me in the prelims. But the point is that you cannot ignore any one aspect of the exam. So usually, for example, culture is left out, or certain parts of environment are left out, and within culture also there are so many aspects, or ancient history some people don't like. But please understand that on any given day, in any given year, you can be asked questions from any sort of topic. So you have to distribute your time in such a way that you devote time to each of the topics which are there in the exam, because each of them is equally important. Even if ek do questions aayenge, that can make a difference, because I think in 14 I cleared prelims by 1 mark, and I wrote the main. So the point is that you never know how things are going to pan out in the longer run. So apart from that, I would just like to talk about the third thing which is there in the exam, which is belief. So before the results came out, and even when I was told about the results this time around, when the final result came out, and one of my friends called me up and said that, he asked me my roll number, because my name was already there. So when I told him my roll number, and he told me that I got 7th rank. So, you know, it was a lot of disbelief. I did not think, and that happens with everyone. See, please understand that even a person who's getting the first rank does not know whether he'll be in the list or not. Because sometimes that there's that window of luck which has to open for you, I think. And but the effort has to be consistent. Because whenever that window is opening, and if your effort falls short, you might not make it. So just to imagine yourself in that final PDF. And for me, like, mains was a block for some time, because 13 and 14 I did not clear mains. So I could not imagine my name in the mains result PDF. So in 15 when I finally cleared, then I saw, okay, achha, this can happen. So please understand that you got to have belief. You got to understand that this is an exam where there is a lot of uncertainty, and you have to keep up your effort to be able to stay competitive. Just stay competitive. And there are a lot of brilliant people who clear in the first or second attempt also. And the point with them is that they get their strategy right in the first attempt itself. So like I mentioned with public administration, whether you call it ego or whatever, I never took any guidance. I did not write even one answer. So see, that is going to cost you, because ultimately there are people who are writing answers who are doing very good, and to be able to meet up with their level or do better. And please understand again that standing out is difficult, but if you plan it out properly, for example in GS, so I have scored 382 marks in last year's attempt in GS, and this time around I have scored 470 marks, which is, I think, second All India highest. 473 is All India highest marks in GS. So please see that whatever your prep is, it is strategically aligned to what is the requirement of the exam. So I just gave you one example when you are reading an article or a Yojana article, ki answer mein ye use ho payega ki nahi. Number one aspect is that. And then again from the exam angle, you think that agar let's say health pe koi question aayega ya education pe koi question aayega. There's a lot of people who make very brilliant notes. Unke paas single pages hote hain for each topic. For example, food processing ke liye they'll have one page. And no matter what question comes from food processing, you can fit that data and you know, make a few interconnections and write a good answer. So I think that is a very good approach. I was not able to follow that because I'm not a very rigorous note maker or anything, but that always helps. Because again, the second aspect which I feel, apart from ye sochna ki answer mein ye likh payenge ki nahi, the second is ki hum revise kar payenge ki nahi mains mein. So again, I feel that no matter how many mock tests you take for the mains exam, I have written 4 mains exam. So that 1 week cannot be replicated. You cannot have that same thing in a mock, because you know, you write 9 to 12, 2 to 5, and then again you have to go next day and write 9 to 12, 2 to 5. You'll never do that in your mocks, right? Because that push is not there, unless it is absolutely necessary, which is in the mains exam. You don't do that, right? So please understand ki jab wo 12 se 2 ka time hoga, ya aap shaam ko wapis aayenge aur subah aapko jana hoga fir se paper likhne ke liye, tab aap kya revise kar payenge, right? And why I'm saying making notes or making single pages for each article is important, kyunki agar aapke paas wo hoga, it's much easier to revise. So I always suffered because of that, because I had to go back to the books or these booklets. Inse bhi maine notes nahi banaye the. One can do that. So you always had so much bulk to look through, and puts undue pressure on you. So ultimately, what you're writing in your answer is in your latent memory or is in your front memory, and whatever you've revised in the last few hours, probably in my case, that comes out to be the best. So I cannot afford to miss revision in the last few hours before the exam. So please see ki main ye revise kar paunga ki nahi. Will I be able to put this on the schedule before writing my paper in mains? So once you do that, you will see that bahut optimize ho raha hai whatever you are reading, and you will be directly able to import it into your answer. Because unless that is happening, it doesn't matter. Aap kitni bhi books padh lein, kitne bhi sources refer kar lein, answer mein agar import nahi ho raha hai wo data, to it will make no sense. So answer writing is important for the mains. Again, in my first 2 attempts, I was also working, so there was a paucity of time also. But I did not write any answers. Maine seedha mains hi likha tha jaake. Because you know, I had that belief ki theek hai, likh to sakte hi hai, and it's okay. And I used to be able to write, like largely, aisa nahi tha ki I used to miss out on the paper or anything. But again, please understand ki it's an art which you have to develop. no matter how good you are with language, no matter how good, how confident you are with answer writing, unless you write in the exam environment for 3 hours, unless you attempt 20 questions, you will not come to know what is your level. And that is the best you can do. As I said, you cannot attempt 9 papers in 1 week, like in mains, but at least you can sit for 3 hours and evaluate what is happening. So for example, this time around when I took Pol Science optional, so I was doing classes and also test series. I did not join any GS test series this time because I thought I could manage that. Last year also I had scored well. So I was reading these booklets and mostly focusing on Pol Science. So what I used to do for Pol Science test is, I used to, you know, take 2.5 hours exactly. And that used to be my cutoff, ki itne mein finish karna hai, though we have 3 hours. But once you set that limit for yourself, I finished 6 out of 8 tests or something in 2.5 hours, where I left 1 or 2 questions sometimes, or sometimes attempted the whole thing. So this is one aspect which I feel a lot of people do not talk about, is speed. So speed of writing and thinking. So like I said, I've written 4 mains, and my experience with mains has been that from day one, paper one, essay paper, to the last paper, you are always writing. You know, there's hardly any time to think. Because ultimately, those 3 hours, you know, when you're writing the answer, and even if you look away for a second, you might lose your chain of thought and waste a couple of minutes. Because you have like 10 minutes per answer, and you have to optimize your time in that. So then also there is this conundrum of how to, whether to fill the space in the answer booklet or not. And because there's a lot of space there. So if you try filling that, maybe 15th question tak aate aate, you'll realize ki abhi to half an hour bacha and you have to write 5 questions. So you have to work on your speed. And also if you have more content per answer, if you are able to write fast and put in more content in each answer, fill those pages. Again, filling pages is not the point. The point is having content. So the only thing I changed from last mains to this mains, especially in GS, is that I wrote more. I wrote a lot of content in my answers. So mostly there were always a couple of questions in GS which no one had an idea about. Let's say there was Western Africa freedom struggle or McBride Commission. One or two questions were always there which you could not attempt. So maybe 18 or 19 you were attempting with full vigor. So those 18 and 19 questions, I made sure that I could put in as much, I put in as much content as I can. Because it's very difficult to stand out unless for per answer, let's say even if you get 1 mark more per answer, that would fetch you 80 marks in GS, greater than everyone else. And getting that 1 mark, again, it's a matter of practice. So what I would say is having your conclusions lengthier always helps. So in my first 2 attempts in mains, I have not written a lot of conclusions. My answers were having a very jarred end to it, and there were no conclusions. But there are always questions, and in fact, in most of the questions, what the examiner is looking for, ki aapka point of view kya hai? Where do you stand on these things? So it's all good to be ambivalent and taking the middle way or having a balanced approach. But there are decisions to be made in administration. So sometimes you have to take that stand. So I keep giving this example when Article 370 wala question tha last year, ki whether it should be abrogated or not. So what is your stand on it? So it's all very good to talk about the pros and cons and everything. But ultimately, in the conclusion, I said that it should not be abrogated because currently the integration is not complete. So sometimes I think we detest from writing facts which we feel are politically incorrect or something. Let's say it will be very difficult for us to write that Pakistan is a security threat, even though the whole world knows it is, right? So sometimes you have to break that ambivalence and go into it. So especially in Pol Science, when I was writing the IR wale answers, so I made sure that I kept it very frugal, very normal, and I talked about, you know, the basic things rather than a lot of rhetoric. So you have to cut down on the rhetoric also. And the second thing in the answer writing especially, which I feel, is the interconnectivity. So why, you know, I keep talking about these booklets is that this is topic wise, right? So each of these topics can be a question in the mains. I'll give you a very simple example. In 2015, in my ED class, when I was sitting in the same class and doing current affairs, there was a topic which sir gave. It was called the strategic angle of Project Mausam. That was the topic itself. And there were like 3 pages devoted to it. And in the mains, there was a question, does Project Mausam have a strategic aspect in the same year? So the point is, a lot of coverage can happen if you follow the issue wise current affairs. So other monthly supplements, which I feel are available in the market, they give you a very good view for prelims. You know, it's very factual, it's very headline based, but ultimately for mains you have to think issue based and not headline based, because one issue will be asked, let's say LGCM relationship in Delhi, or like I said, Article 370 or Uniform Civil Code was a question in 15. And trust me, all of these topics have been covered in such great depth in these booklets. So sometimes it becomes a little voluminous also for you. So that's why I'm suggesting ki jaise, for example, I have a booklet in front of me for April, 16 to 22nd April. So let's say we have VVPAT this time. So I feel that it's a very expected question this time in mains, right? So ED class 20 booklet I have in front of me. So VVPAT, a step to foolproof tampering. So if you can expect a question from this, again, the questions which UPSC gives, you got to go back to the papers, you got to see what is the pattern. So they might not ask you about VVPAT, they might ask you about election reform. So the question is always at a level higher than you would think. It's not you know, the nitty-gritties or the smaller aspects which are important, but an overall view of things. So VVPAT you can use in your answer probably, and of course there can be a question directly on VVPAT also, but that's less likely. So that's been my experience with UPSC. So like I said, for health, etc., or education, you'll not be asked about a particular scheme. You'll be asked about an overall view of things, about how the programs are failing, or what can be done better, or what is there in this policy which was not there earlier, something like that. So for example, let's say VVPAT wala isme jo topic hai, if you look through that, so I was looking through it and it's just the same feeling, because last time also. So this is, first of all, I mean, I cannot tell you how comprehensive this is, because first of all, they have talked about, you know, there is a legal status about the VVPAT, the timeline. And please understand, you will read all this, but you will not be able to write in your answer all of this. But even if you are able to write one line from each of these sections, your answer will be very enriched, because let's say we have talked about understanding VVPAT, which is the basic, then pros and cons, which we have talked about, then the way forward, right? And in most of the topics, you will have this sort of an approach to things, where jahan pe, matlab, where you feel that now the thinking has stopped, or now I've talked about all aspects, it talks about two more aspects. So for example, let's say look is policy hai. So everyone would, or act east policy ab ban gayi hai, so everyone would talk about how Southeast Asia is important, and how India has aligned itself, how economic interests are there, and but again, you have to go one level higher. You got to see how political epicenter is shifting to Pacific Ocean, how China is rising, sea lanes of communication. All of this is relevant. And then reaching out to countries like Japan, PM Modi's visits, I mean, they are growing by the day. So IR has become a very, very important section for GS2. But whatever questions come in IR, again, you can have a framework. Be very, very strategic in your, for example, whatever country it may be, can talk about economic aspects, defense aspects, cultural aspects, people to people, let's say environmental aspects, or all of these things, climate change. And all of these things fit everywhere. And then you can have some specifics. For example, you can have border issues with Bangladesh, or fishermen issues with Sri Lanka. So these are a few specifics which we are all aware of. And then have a bit of framework ki ye panch cheezein to likhni hai, whether it is cultural or people to people or economic or defense or and so on and so forth, trade. So once you have that framework in answer, wahan pe sochna nahi padega. Like I said, ki likhna hi padta hai. 3 hours you have to keep writing. So like I said, I was finishing in 2.5 hours here in the mock tests, but again, they are mock tests. So when I wrote the actual exam, I used to finish 5 minutes earlier only. So, and with that kind of speed, once you're writing that much content, there's hardly anything you can do. I mean, humanly possible nahi hai, right? And once you've hit that limit, you know this is the best that a person can do, right? If your content is relevant, if there is too much, there's a lot of content, so usse zyada aap kuch nahi kar sakte, right? And no one will be able to do more than that. So, you know, this again connects with belief, that you have to believe that what you have done is enough. What you have done, isse zyada karna possible nahi hai. So in prelims, I've taken it 4 times, cleared it all 4 times. So the point which I kept in mind in prelims, ki koi question aata tha, if it was very obscure, and there are at least 20 to 25 questions which are, you know, very difficult to get right, in the exam. So once you look at a question and you know that you have read all the basic sources, you have kept a tab on current affairs, and still आपको बिल्कुल हवा नहीं है उस question की, तो please understand कि किसी को नहीं होगी. It's not an exam where you have to get all the questions right. Right? It's about getting the right strategy. So in prelims, I was always very conservative in attempting the papers. So 77 was the maximum amount of questions I have attempted in my 4 attempts. So, and 77 used to serve me in good stead, क्योंकि 10-15 गलत भी हो जाते थे, I used to clear the cut off. Some people have a different strategy, and again that can come with mocks. And I was discussing with sir about prelims. So again, you know, the explosion of material, the kind of biases we have in our heads, कि जितने ज़्यादा sources से हम कर लेंगे, that will help us. So for prelims, I have seen people take at least 3 or 4 test series also, and not look at the UPSC papers itself. So I don't know how many of you would be aware, but in 2014, I think, yes, 15 in fact, there was a question which was an absolute repeat of the 14 question, which was about Buddha's connection with places, right? You would be aware of that. So that was a complete bouncer. You know, if you've not looked at the answer key, because that was a disputed question, and when UPSC released its answer key, only then we knew what the correct answer was. And fortunately, I had seen it. So, you know, UPSC में जो पूछा जा रहा है, once you're looking at the past 4 or 5 years paper at least, and have a view of the mains exam also, ki what is the bend of questions, what is being tested here, because in GS1 also now, you know, when I talk about connectivity, so in GS1 also this time around there was a question on South China Sea, right? So economics is geography, is history, is everything is, you know, interconnected. So when you're looking at, I think there was a question on why battles were fought in Panipat, right? So that's as much history as geography as any other thing, right? Socioeconomic life or whatever you could write there. So you have to place everything in a map. You got to have a map in the head and place it in the larger picture. So yahan pe it's very easy to talk about VVPAT, but the thing that comes in your, that should come in your mind is election reform. The thing that should come ki kitne countries ne kiya hai, what is you know, voter secrecy, what are the provisions, and so on and so forth. You got to expand that horizon, and then how it is connected to service delivery or e-governance and so on and so forth. So ultimately interconnectivity jitni zyada ho gayi, and then the second type of questions which I said ki open ended questions hote hain jahan pe you don't know ki pucha kya ja raha hai. So there was one question in mains GS3 I think ki useless manpower or something, there was one question ki excessive or useless manpower, how do you handle something like that. So a lot of people wrote about skill development, so that was one. But you know, you have to expand your thinking. You have to see ki matlab where can excessive manpower be. So even in the corporate sector there can be excessive manpower, when you know, on a project if there are 10 people, only 2 are needed. So even that is somewhere a disguised unemployment sort of a thing. So useless manpower, yes, skilling is an aspect. Then there are you know, that aspect you can think of when people are sure they'll get a job under MNREGA, so they're not acquiring any skills and just taking. So you have to keep thinking laterally, you have to keep interconnecting, and there's less time for that. So there is of course, you know, practice needed. So ultimately you have a practice about interlinking various things, and that's where these ED booklets, I feel, there's no other source I have not seen personally which, you know, offers such a issue based analysis of things. So in, I owe whatever marks I have in GS to these booklets, especially in GS2 and 3. GS1 and 4 are very static portions. So again, that will depend on how well you can go back to the sources and how well you can reproduce things. So the other thing I'd like to talk about is also, so there are always sections, there are always subjects which you don't like, right? So in my case, it was geography. So sometimes, you know, you just can't get a hang of things. So in my engineering, it was electrical engineering. I scored 40 in 2 of my semesters because I couldn't get the hang of it. Sometimes, you know, just not made for it. Aptitude nahi hota hai. It's like cooking hai, so I don't have an aptitude for cooking, no matter how hard I try. So that was the case with geography. So what to do in such a situation where, you know, aapko bahut padhne ke baad bhi, bahut effort lagane ke baad bhi, you're not getting the results. So again, what I did with geography was I went back to what was needed in the exam. So what I did was I picked up a lot of solved GS1 papers from the market, right? And usme matlab initially 13 and 14 there were 25 questions which were coming. So last 10 questions geography ke hote the. सो आई डिड अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, मैं क्वेश्चंस के थ्रू ही ज्योग्राफी कवर कर लिया मैंने, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली यू हैव टू राइट एन आंसर, राइट? सो दैट इज़ द पॉइंट. इवन इफ सम एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ योर प्रिपरेशन आर वीक एंड दे विल ऑलवेज बी, बट यू गॉट टू फाइंड अ वे अराउंड देम, यू गॉट टू फाइंड. एंड नाउ यू नो द क्वेश्चंस इन ज्योग्राफी आर बिकमिंग मोर एंड मोर जनरल, सो वेदर इट इज़ अर्बन फ्लडिंग और लाइक आई सेड साउथ चाइना सी पे भी क्वेश्चन था. सो अर्लियर दे यूज टू आस्क मोर स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस, एंड इफ यू लुक एट द ट्रेंड इन फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी देर इज ओनली अ लिमिटेड नंबर ऑफ टॉपिक्स दैट यू नीड टू कवर. वही साइक्लोन, सुनामी, अल्टीमेटली घुमा फिरा के वही PS waves. So that is what is there. And if you look at the papers also, ki these things have already been asked, you can almost make out what will be asked now, right? Because unke bhi questions ultimately kitne questions koi banayega, kahan se aayenge questions. So the source for GS 2 and 3 in my case was current affairs, and why I could do the static portion of GS 2 well, I would like to talk about that because that has been asked. So because I had an optional with public administration, so I had that part a little strong, and then Paul Science also has Indian administration wala part. So, but I would say that apart from Lakshmikanth, which people refer for the prelims, probably you can go to a few chapters in DD Basu, or you know, pick up certain online material. Again, I didn't do that because I was reading the books for Indian administration. But you got to have like this time in prelims, I was very surprised ki polity mein jo questions hain, they were so philosophical, and they were, you know, they were focusing on the basics, ki, you know, the genius of ordinary people, that's what democracy is about. So these are the things you'll, you know, these are the structures over which the whole polity is built. So once you understand that, what is the division of power, what is the executive doing? So, and for example, CAG pe question aaya tha last year, ki how it should interact with the government, so how it should be a friend, philosopher, guide and everything. So all of this, you know, you can get through some other books. Lakshmikanth has a lot of factual information, and again, if you're following issue based things, again I feel that a lot of things will be covered from here. And apart from this, another source which I referred in 15 but not in 16 due to lack of time was Inside Secure Compilation. So see, that's an open source initiative, that is something which is available to everyone, and if you cover questions from there daily initiative for 6 months, let's say, just pick up a compilation. Don't overburden yourself ki aapko har din 5 question likhne, because that will not be useful. Aapko 5 nahi likhne, aapko 20 questions likhne, right? So it's much easier if you just Saturday ko aap ek test likhne 3 ghante ka, rather than writing 2 answers every day, because then the bias comes. Because if you're writing one answer, you feel like ki bas isko bahut acche se kar dena hai, and you can invest 15 minutes also onto it, which is not there in the exam. You'll not be able to do that. तो जो रिक्वायरमेंट है अल्टीमेटली वही कीजिए. एंड इन माई केस दैट हैज़ बिन मिसिंग इन द फर्स्ट 3 अटैम्प्ट्स. आई फील इन फैक्ट बाई द थर्ड अटैम्प्ट आई हैड कम टू नो कि क्या मिसिंग है एंड वॉट इज़ गोइंग रॉन्ग. बट अल्टीमेटली इफ यू नॉट राइटिंग आंसर्स, इफ यू नॉट प्रैक्टिसिंग टेस्ट, इफ यू नॉट डूइंग करंट अफेयर्स लेटरली हॉरिजॉन्टली, इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मेक अ मार्क इन द एग्जामिनेशन, राइट? एंड ऑफकोर्स हैविंग बिलीफ. सो इन माई केस इट अप्लाइज वेरी वेल, बिकॉज वेन आई से दैट you know, I have perseverance, a lot of people connect with me. But again, it's a function of a lot of things. Just say in my case, you know, it was an incremental performance. Every year I was doing slightly better. So first time around I missed mains cutoff by 40 marks. Then I missed it by 20 marks. Then I cleared it by 20-25 marks. This time I think I've cleared by 120 marks or something. So it has been an incremental journey, and you see that things which you are doing are working for you, and if you are working on your mistakes. So that is another lesson from this exam, ki random exam nahi hai. It's not random. And trust me, whatever I have written in my papers in mains, the marks have been more or less you know, in concurrence with what I have written. So in GS1, in my first attempt, I scored 41 marks. Because geography nahi aati thi. So I didn't attempt a lot of, and then I was working also. So maine mains Dena itself was a challenge for me. I took a leave for 1 week and wrote the exam. So then in my second attempt, I got 65 marks, I think. Then in my third attempt, I got 93 or 94 marks. And this time I have 119 marks. So point is, you can improve. Point is ki mere case mein ye tha ki syllabus complete nahi tha. Lot of things, GS1 is specially vast because you have culture and world history and social issues and everything is there in GS1. Is, I think, one of the most challenging things to cover completely. So for example, if you have taken prelims and you're waiting for the prelims result, what you can do is you can revise the static portion till that time, because see, that thing is always there, ki cutoff kya hogi, how I have done. And but please don't waste time in that waiting process. because that 1 month can be crucial. So you can, you know, go to your essay or GS4 or you know, the static part of GS1, because ultimately padhna to hai hai, and after the prelims result you can probably go to current affairs and practice answer writing. So please divide your time and keep it matlab, in proximity to whatever is needed. So jaise prelims aane wala hai, so let's say 2 months before you start practicing tests, because you know, you get into that, aap 6 mahine pehle se test practice karenge, so I'm not sure how effective that will be, but 2 mahine pehle se aap test practice karenge, so your mind will be in that framework. And when you're writing answers, again, you don't have to write answers for the entire year. Yes, more and more practice is important, but keep it in proximity to what is needed. Jab exam ho, usse 1 mahine pehle ya 2 mahine pehle, whatever suits you. Some of you, you've already appeared, so you'll have that practice of writing answers. And well, apart from that, selecting optional, I have received a lot of queries ki pubad mein kya hua and is it a bad optional or why did you change it. So again, I would say that ye sab biases hain, and there are a lot of biases which operate in UPSC, matlab which are there in our heads but which are not really there. So whether it is about interview boards ki aapko ye interview board mila hai, so you know, you'll get good marks, or whether it is about the optional, this particular optional is performing well. If you look at the optional of top 25 people this time, I mean, you will see the diversity which I have not seen earlier. There are 2 people from PABAD in top 10. There are 3 from Pol Science, there is mathematics, there is chemistry, there is Kannada literature. So the point is, every optional succeeds. And but aisa nahi hai ki, you know, if you take a particular optional, you have a birthright to clear the exam, because it's very simple. Because in my case, when I took PABAD, the thinking was that since I was working, so the syllabus is lesser, so I'll be able to cover and all of that. But that's not always the case. Syllabus is never lesser. So when you know, the written syllabus is lesser, probably the questions which can be asked, you know, it requires more interlinking and lateral reading from there. So I did not do well with that. So while selecting your optional, whatever it is, whether it is a graduation subject or whatever it is that you are choosing, make sure you have material available, make sure you practice, because optional marks again matter a lot. And in the overall score, in last year when I reached the interview, I had good marks in GS, good marks in SA. In PABAD, I had 191 marks. So you know, that sort of kills your chances altogether. You will not make it to the final list. So this time around, I have 302 marks in Pol Science. People have scored more also. So the point being that optional marks are significant, and when you're writing your optional answer, so whatever it is, a lot of social sciences optional are such that GSA overlap hota hai, bahut kuch similar hota hai, especially jaise IR hai Pol Science mein, ya sociology ka paper 2. Paper 2 is mostly applied for most of the optionals. So how do you differentiate your answer from a GS answer? How do you tell the examiner that you're writing an optional answer? So again, there are 2 levels of interconnectivity which are needed. So one is from paper 1. So whatever theory you have read in paper 1, try to fit that thing into paper 2. Ki kuch frameworks hote hain, kuch theoretical basis hote hain for every sort of relationship, let's say India-Pakistan. So in Pol Science, we have a concept called social constructivism, which says that jo relations hain, they're not really like that, but you know, because of how things are portrayed in the media or how think tanks put it, तो वो इट बिकम्स अ कंस्ट्रक्टिव व्यू. सोशल सोसाइटी कंस्ट्रक्ट कर देती है ऐसा व्यू कि पाकिस्तान इज़ एन एनिमी, राइट? सो दैट आई वॉज एबल टू इंक्लूड इट एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फॉर. दिस इज जस्ट वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स. एंड वो कनेक्टिविटी एंड द सेकेंड लेवल ऑफ कनेक्टिविटी, अगेन वैन यूर राइटिंग टू डिफ्रेंशिएट इट फ्रॉम द जी एस आंसर, इज प्रॉबेबली यू नो, यू कैन राइट अ फ्यू व्यूज ऑफ प्रोमिनेंट और एक्सपर्ट्स इन जी एस पेपर 2 ऑफ योर ऑप्शनल, बिकॉज दैट शोज दैट ठीक है, यू हैव dwelt onto that thing, and you have to write your own view also. Again, that becomes even more important. Ultimately, what they are looking for is what you have to say about it. So conclusions ko thoda lamba rakhiye, intros can be short, ek do line ke introductions ho sakte hain, but conclusions can be longer. And well, apart from that, I think ultimately in the prep, you have to divide time, you have to devote time, like I said, to each topic, and keep following current affairs, keep practicing. And you know, those are the, and GS4, I'll just talk about GS4 a bit. We have classes here also. I've not personally done any coaching for GS4, but I've scored well. So GS4 mein I feel that there are a few things which you can care about. Again, connectivity is important, but how do you connect? So when you're writing a GS4 answer, especially when you're writing a case study, let's say, So for that, you have to use GS2 also. So even though it's an ethics paper, ultimately it's a governance paper. Ultimately, you know, you are being given a governance or an administrative problem to solve. So once you're an administrator, you've got to know the framework of the government. Because ultimately, जो भी question है उसमें explicitly mentioned नहीं होता है, but you are operating in India, right? So whatever that case study is, so that thing is taking place in the Indian context. So you can always quote articles from GS2, from the Constitution. You can always quote bodies. You can always fix responsibility. कि ठीक है, it's all very easy to say कि awareness फैलाना है village में about women empowerment, but कौन फैलाएगा, right? So you have to write panchayats or any other local body or parastatals or whatever it may be, right? So fix responsibility so that the examiner knows ki you have a grip on the structure of the government and who does what also. And apart from that, the second aspect is have some sort of a graphical. So I think that GS4 becomes a little monotonous because the answers are longer than the other GS papers. So you know, you can have some sort of a graphical analysis of things. So for example, in my last two attempts, I have scored 98 and this time I have scored 124 in ethics. So what I used to do is, after each case study especially, I used to make a SWOT chart. And this I had learned from Ira Singhal ma'am back in the day. I think she talked about something approaching a case study. So what is a SWOT chart essentially is that, you know, you talk about the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. And don't take too much space. Strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. So with the current case, whatever case you're attempting, you can write a few keywords after, you know, you've suggested the course of action. So let's say that in strengths, you can have legal or institutional framework. And then in weaknesses, you can have, let's say, exclusion or violence or discrimination. Then what are the opportunities that you have? Again, inclusive development, women empowerment. So some sort of, you know, bird's eye view. What are the threats? Threats, again, exclusion, whatever, discrimination, violence. So you can, according to the given case, you can have some sort of a macro bird's eye view. So what the examiner sees here is that you are thinking one level above. You are aware of what are the ideals of the Constitution. You can talk about, let's say, equality or right against discrimination. You can quote articles there also. So ultimately, he sees that you are aware of what is the constitutional and legal framework of things and what is being achieved and what is being prevented. So sometimes, you know, that misses out in the overall, because 3-4 courses of action hote hain and you know which is the best one, right? Because it's very clear ki best one kaun sa hai. But ultimately, once you write that analysis, I think this helps, or it could be in some other manner also. This was my approach. So SWOT analysis was my approach, but and it helped me get more marks, I think, because this time I attempted the case studies really well. So I think that has helped me get more marks into ethics. And
SWOT analysis for every course.
Yes. No, at the end of the case study, after I attempted the whole question. Yes. So in the last, I took only this much space in the answer sheet and I wrote an overall bird's eye view of the whole case. Yes, more or less. It's a graphical conclusion, so it's very easy to look at it also. So imagine you being an examiner and checking a monotonous copy filled with words. It's very difficult to, you know, highlight things. And so I did that with the essay also. I readability improve karna hai aapko ultimately. So 3 attempts mein maine jo essay likhe the, usse maine kya change kiya is time, that I put up subheadings. So kya hota hai ki 10-12 page ka hota hai, it becomes very monotonous for the person who's checking. He doesn't know ki aap kahan pe kya baat kar rahe hain. So it sometimes helps to put up you know, subtopics within the essay. And quotes and all, again, flowery language, that depends on you, you know, if you can pull it off. But I, in my experience, I think simple language is the best and flow is the most important in the essay. If you're talking about cons or pros, ek jagah pe baat kijiye, fir baad mein jaake aapko koi pro yaad aaye to wahan pe, because that breaks the flow. Even when you read the essay, you'll not like it very much. Also keep a tab on the content and the space which you have for the essay. So in, again, my 4 attempts, I have always finished each essay on the last page. That is not to say, you know, that I've filled pages, but the point is that that gives the examiner a feeling that you are a very, you know, you have structured it so well that you have concluded it at the right place. Obviously, if you finish 3 pages earlier, you know, it will look like a short essay, right? So please have that understanding ki aap jab framework banate hain, Let's say I took about half an hour to make an overall framework of the essay and then attempt it. So jab aap framework banate hain, whatever subtopics you're writing, maybe write the number of pages also in front of it. Ki agar 10 page likhne hain and if you have 10 topics, so you know, have this ki ek page tak mujhe social issues ki baat karni hai, for the next page I'll, so that sort of helps you give equal attention to each aspect and conclude properly at the end of the essay also. And I have written very, very simple essays in all my four attempts, and I usually scored, let's say, 126, 133. This time I have scored 148. This time people have scored much better also. So this happened with me that in the first essay, I could not decide for 20 minutes ki kaun sa essay likhna hai. So my time management got messed up. I wrote the second essay well, but the first one, you know, I messed up the time management. So be very, again, choosing the essay topic. I think that's also something that needs to be talked about, because wahan pe bhi bahut biases hote hain. Some people say that you know, if you're choosing a topic which nobody else will choose, you will have an advantage, but that's incorrect. You will not have an advantage and you will not have a disadvantage if you are choosing you know, which everyone will choose also, because ultimately aapko 10 12 pages tak quality content likhna hai. So if you know, choose an obscure topic which you're not very aware of, jaise last year there was a topic on interstate water disputes. So maybe I could write an answer for that, but an essay I was not very sure about. So I picked up the easier one, need and greed wala jo essay tha, that's what I wrote, right? So ultimately aapko 10 pages the quality, and I always used to choose a slightly philosophical essay, because that gives you latitude to explore various angles. Matlab aap usme content management kar sakte hain. So let's say need and greed wala jo essay hai, usme initially you can talk about the topic a little bit. What is need? What is the origin of human need? What can be a good need or a bad need, and you know, how it's related to greed, how, when it converts to greed, and then, you know, social aspects, environmental aspects of it. So it's very easy to fit all of these things into an essay which is not exact, you know, which is philosophical, which is a quote or something. So that always suited me. So for some people koi specific essay hota hai, that suits. But ultimately one other thing which you can do for essay is, if you look at the questions in the last few years, what you will see is ki kuch na kuch you can categorize ki science se ek aise hota hai, ek philosophical type ka hota hai, ek kuch democracy type ka hota hai. So you know, there is a only limited set of topics from which the essay comes. So to have the illusion of depth, you know, so I have used this term quite often in my talks and my interactions, ki sometimes you might not have depth, but you can give the illusion of depth, like I did with geography, right? So essay mein aisa nahi hai ki aapko 100 quotes aate hain. Just keep 10 quotes on an A4 sheet, right? And one day before, revise those 10 quotes, and whatever essay comes, fit that quote into there. So ultimately the examinable thing ki acha ye topic bhi aaya hai, to you have a quote ready for that, right? But ultimately you have read only 10 quotes. So that's the illusion of depth that you can give the examiner. Like I said with geography, you know, by attempting questions, I was able to give the illusion of depth ki mujhe bahut achhi geography aati hai, which is not the case. So that is also sometimes ki jahan pe aapko bahut zyada lag raha hai, jaise culture mein there are a lot of things which need to be covered, but since jaise aapne ek do attempt diye hain, so you have the other aspects ready, to thoda sa dynamism is important. Thoda sa kya hai ki jaise this time I said ki GS mein I didn't devote time, I devoted time. So only you are aware of your level of preparation, only you are aware of your strong points and your weak points. And the other thing about strong points is, do not not practice your strong points, because you know, the strong point can become your excellent point and give you a lot of things. So if you ignore your strong points also, that will not help you. Weaknesses pe to work karna hi karna hai, but you have to sort of align your time according to your level of prep. So I cannot suggest you ki aap GS1 mein kam time dijiye. Some of you would be more comfortable with GS1 and so on and so forth, right? So be very, very aware of map pe aap kahan hai, jaise GPS pe वो डॉट आता है. सो प्लीज़ बी अवेयर वेयर आर यू एंड वेयर यू हैव टू रीच, राइट? बिकॉज अवेयरनेस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, अदरवाइज यू विल गेट लॉस्ट. द लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टू कवर, एंड लाइक आई सेड इन प्रीलिम्स, यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द ऑब्स्क्योर क्वेश्चंस. इवन इन मेंस यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द ऑब्स्क्योर क्वेश्चंस. मैकब्राइड कमीशन, यू नो, आई वॉज रेडी टू साइन ऑन अ डॉक्यूमेंट दैट नो वन इन द प्रेपरेशन वुड नो दिस, राइट? बिकॉज इट्स वेरी ऑब्स्क्योर, इट्स जस्ट सम रैंडम कमीशन फ्रॉम सम रैंडम ईयर एंड दे आर आस्किंग इंडिया स्टैंड, एंड इट वॉज सच अ स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन दैट यू कैनॉट बीट अराउंड द बुश ऑल्सो. They are asking about what the commission is about and what is India's stand on it. So what do you write? You know, it's much better to not write. Sometimes, yes, it always helps ki aapko ek number zyada mil jaye, तो आपकी रैंक इंप्रूव हो जाएगी. सो यू कैन राइट समथिंग एंड यू शुड, विच इज़ माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग. बट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू यू नो राइट एनीथिंग. सो दैट कैन हैपन. एंड प्लीज़ अंडरस्टैंड कि वो डिसाइडिंग क्वेश्चन नहीं होगा. क्वेश्चन वो डिसाइडिंग होगा सब अटैम्प्ट कर रहे हैं, राइट. सो वहाँ पे आपको एक एक नंबर ज़्यादा लाना है, दो दो नंबर ज़्यादा लाना है पर क्वेश्चन, सो दैट यू नो यू कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस. सो दैट इज़ अबाउट आंसर राइटिंग एंड अबाउट हाउ टू अप्रोच करेंट अफेयर्स. एंड इफ यू गाइज हैव एनी क्वेश्चन वी कैन टेक इट.
यस.
So for example, a few chapters are always relevant. Fundamental rights is good in that Panchayati Raj, there are always questions from there, or other constitutional, non-constitutional bodies are also there. For example, I mentioned CAG and its relationship with the government. So election commission, or what is the extent of power that can be given. So wherever you can think of an issue-based thing, current affairs se relate karke, is the election commission can come, right? Because it's been in the news. And so current se relate karke, more or less whatever you see. That apart from that, a lot of people refer to second ARC also, but I feel unless your optional is that, you know, maybe you can refer to a summary, but sometimes it becomes very voluminous to refer to. But it has also a very good coverage of, if you can pick up a summary, it has a very good coverage of the structure of the government, ethics ke upar hai, usme corruption ke upar hai. There are a lot of pointers you can get and use in your answers. So that is the second source which you can refer to if you have time. Yes. 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 Right. Okay. So that's a good question because, like I said, you know, whatever are your strengths. So because I have been preparing for 3-4 years, so I already have a big database of knowledge which I can use in GS. So I was able to afford to devote less time in GS. And for pol science, I was simply running after classes, actually getting up each morning and trying to attend classes. Sometimes I was not able to do that. But the point is that even within pol science, there are aspects which, you know, I was strong on, like IR. IR was something I had been following for a long time. And it's something that I'm interested in also. Apart from that, Indian administration, which is a part of pol science. So basically, I had to prepare only, so out of, let's say, paper one has two parts, paper two has two parts. So ultimately, I had to prepare only two parts. So it might look like I prepared in 4 months, but actually, you know, I had already a database of knowledge before that. So I think for any optional, you need at least 4-5 months to prepare, and it's not advisable to switch your optional in July and take the mains in December, right? So I would not suggest that. But in my case, since, you know, I had reached a plateau and PABAD was not giving me results, I had to do something, right? So I think, and again, getting good marks. I think yesterday, day before yesterday, somebody called me and I was not aware of this, that I have All India highest marks in paper two of pol science, which certainly I attempted very simply. And, you know, I wrote what I thought. Again, IR has been strong, but again, you know, there are some things which can click for you. So if I had gotten 190 in pol science, it would have been a bad decision, right? So there are some things which need to click for you also. This time, everyone has scored more marks in general also. So I think, but choose your optional very wisely, because I think I lost out on all of this time because of the wrong choice of optional. So you're planning to switch now? You know, but see, if you get good guidance, if you have good strategy for any optional, you can score well. Last time, it has done truly well. I think somebody has scored 336 also in PABAD, right? Abhilash has scored 336, right? Yeah. So, yes.
So, you have emphasized on longer conclusions.
Yes.
So, like, was there a particular framework or strategy followed for writing conclusions, or were they just spontaneous going with the flow of the question?
Yes, I would say that there is very limited time. Like I said, there's very limited time. But again, while you're writing the answer, then also you have to keep thinking, right? So thinking and writing fast. I remember reading this in Ananya Das's blog back when she had written pol science strategy. So the faster you think, the faster you write, right? And that fast thinking will develop with practice. So with all of the database of, let's say, ED class booklets you have, or whatever other you know, sources you have referred to, ultimately while you're writing the answer, keep thinking about what stand you'll take in the conclusion. And you know, when you're concluding, then things come to mind. You know, sometimes you can relate things. So I can give you an example. For example, you can relate, let's say, two disparate aspects, and let's say for example, Skill India can be related to National Nutrition Mission, and how that, I mean, if the children are healthy, they are doing classes and later they can be skilled and so on. So, you know, ultimately it's all about interconnectivity, and what you do there, don't overdo it, because ultimately what the government is doing, there is a certain goal, there is a certain end to things, right? So, if you have that in mind, you can write a balanced conclusion, and while writing you have to think. So you cannot take 2 minutes and then start assigning, because there is no time, in my opinion. I mean, maybe I write slowly because I have only myself to judge against, but you know, if you can manage that, well and good.
But like some say that after conclusion should conclude your answer, some say it should be a way forward, some say that it should be, you know, try collecting the question, how it will solve the grassroots problem. So like, is there a particular framework?
No, so again, that will depend from question to question. So in some questions, you are directly asked your opinion. In some questions, you are only asked the pros and cons. So depending on whatever is being asked, you have to fit according to that. So please be very aware of question ka requirement kya hai, because unless you address that properly, it will be difficult. Kyunki I think ultimately that is also one aspect which we don't understand, ki question mein kuch aur pucha jata hai and we end up writing something else, right? So whether it is discuss or comment. So when it is comment, probably, you know, they are asking for your comment on, and when it's a discussion, you can just discuss, you know, the issues around that laterally. And obviously, it always helps to give a way forward, and you know, they are looking for that. So keep a way forward static everywhere, and then probably taking a stand if the question asks you to take a stand. Okay.
So what about the word limit? Like the JS people, they have word limit problems.
Yeah.
So there's a conflict between how much you can write, so what you have to say, because mostly my answer is they should cross the word limit.
Right.
So we have more time, like we can write more per answer.
So again, I feel that, you know, at that stage, all of that sort of gets blurred, because there is no time for you to judge ki kitna likha hua hai aapne or what is the word limit, right? So, you know, I sort of mainly stuck to the space limit rather than the word limit, because even for the examiner, you have to understand that usually it's not possible to know ki kitna hai. So unless, you know, you are using the whole space in the answer sheet, that is good. Even if you're leaving this much for each answer, that's okay. Depends on your handwriting and your content, right? But ultimately, try to finish within the given space. There's no time to judge the word limit. But more or less, space itna hi hota hai ki you, and time bhi itna hi hota hai ki you are able to write 200 to 250 words only. So it doesn't exceed that usually, unless you are attempting only 15 questions and leaving 5, which in my opinion is not advisable. You have to attempt everything. So, yes.
Sir, for GS paper 4, for static portion, what basic things we must cover?
So there are no good sources for GS4 in my opinion, and Lexicon is a book which can give you an overall view of the syllabus, ki topics kya hai, thoda bahut thinkers ke bare mein hai usme, you know, so wo theek hai, you can refer to that for these keywords which I said, which you can use your own answers, but ultimately you have to be a little frugal with it, thoda sa indigenous type hi approach rakhna hai, because ultimately the kind of questions which are asked are very open-ended, because I think जैसे एक क्वेश्चन था कि विच लीडर इंस्पायर्स यू द मोस्ट और समथिंग व्हाट यू हैव लर्न फ्रॉम हिम, तो इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस के लिए देयर इज रियली नो प्रोटोकॉल कि ये किताब पढ़नी है, और सो यू कैन रेफर टू नोट्स हेयर विच सर गिव्स इन द क्लास, और केस स्टडीज़ जो हैं उस पर ज़्यादा फोकस कीजिए, बिकॉज मार्क्स वहाँ पर ज़्यादा होते हैं, एंड एथिक्स पेपर इन माई ओपिनियन इज स्लाइटली लॉन्गर दैन द रेस्ट ऑफ द जी एस पेपर्स, सो उसमें आपको टाइम का बहुत ध्यान रखना है, एंड प्रॉबेबली इन माई ओपिनियन यू कैन अटेम्प्ट the case studies first and then come back to section A, because kya hota hai ki section A mein last year jaise each question had 2 parts or something, and you know, it became very difficult for me to attempt the whole paper, and ultimately last 2 case studies I don't know what I wrote. So don't let that happen. Case studies acche se attempt kijiye, because per case study you have 20-25 marks, right? So if you do well there, if you are able to present something like this, you can get good marks, right? Yes. So I'm sorry I missed that aspect. So without reading the newspaper, you're not getting anywhere. And if you are reading the newspaper, you'll get everywhere. So when I was working, what I used to do was I used to read only the 5 articles in the editorial, right? And how I used to do it, since pen and paper notes were not possible for me, I used to note down in the Word document and print it later. When, you know, I had, let's say, 10 A4 pages bhar gaye mere, then I used to print it. I mean, obviously there are better ways. If you have time, please make pen and paper notes. Also, don't just read, make notes, because you know, your memory will tell you ki yaad hai, बट याद होता नहीं है. एंड वैन यू ट्राई टू राइट एन आंसर दोज वर्ड्स दोज थिंग्स विल नॉट कम आउट एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गो बैक टू द न्यूज़पेपर. कुछ लोग क्लिपिंग्स रखते हैं, काट के रख लेते हैं, बट अगेन आई फील दैट्स वेरी अनटेनेबल अप्रोच. क्योंकि आप मेंस के टाइम जब लिख रहे होंगे तो क्या रिवाइज करेंगे ना, यू कैन नॉट रिवाइज दैट मच. या सो विथ टाइम यू विल बी एबल टू फिल्टर आउट वॉट आर्टिकल्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. जैसे आई सेड आई फॉर एटलीस्ट वन ईयर इन माई फोर ईयर्स आई फॉलोड ओनली एडिटोरियल. सो एवरी इशू दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम सम ऑर द अदर एंगल विल इवेंचुअली अपियर इन द एडिटोरियल सम वे ऑर द अदर. सो वेदर इट इज वन न्यूज़ पेपर यू आर फॉलोइंग और टू न्यूज़ पेपर्स, इवन इफ यू आर डूइंग द एडिटोरियल इंटरनेशनल पेज थोड़ा बहुत ओवरऑल सो दैट विल हेल्प यू. बिकॉज एंड वॉट इज नीडेड इज कंसिस्टेंसी. डोंट मिस द न्यूज़ पेपर फॉर वन मंथ एंड देन. So don't let that happen. Even if you're doing only those five articles, keep doing those five articles for a length of time and you'll have a good knowledge base of things. So please don't skip newspaper reading. Try to make notes. Again, that query is there ki yaar bahut time lag jata hai and all of that. But again, you have to filter out and slowly you'll be able to do that once you look at the papers, when you've taken an attempt, you'll come to know ki what is being asked, what is important, right? So that way you can do. Yes. Sorry? I'm not very good at it, but a lot of people do it this way ki aap topic wise rakhiye, that is the best way to do it. Or paper wise rakh sakte hain, jaise GS2 ka kuch aaya. So for example, let's say yahan pe you know Indus Water Treaty ka ek hai topic, theek hai. So yahan pe do pages honge, maybe later also it comes in news, to wahan pe do pages aur aayenge. So you know, have a folder, keep loose A4 sheets jahan pe aap aur add kar sakte hain. And I've seen people do that, they do that beautifully. Matlab, again, I'm not that organized. So, but the point is that once you have that, sab kuch ek jagah pe hoga, to it's very easy. Ki Indus pe agar question aayega, Indus Water Treaty pe question aayega, to you will be able to, you know, cover all aspects. So, start, matlab shuru mein, and then online, if you're online friendly, then you can use Evernote, all of that. Those resources are also available. So, that also helps. But ultimately, make sure ki you can go back to it. Unless you can go back to it, it's worthless. So, in whatever way you do it, right? So, yes, anything else?
So,
yes, sorry.
IR has been one of your strongest points. So, any particular strategy regarding your source?
So, I think it's a, in my case, it was.
So, word focus, because that is very.
One magazine I bought, I didn't read that. So, yes, so in my case, I think it's a matter of interest. So, I followed a few websites also. Project Syndicate karke, there's a website which I used to follow, Syndicate. But again, that will be an overkill for you because I think that's more for the optional, unless you have PSIR optional, that is there. And even in the newspapers, there is enough coverage of things and these booklets had a good...
Actually, I'm a political science graduate and then I took up law.
Okay.
So, but then I'm planning law as my option because, but then there are very few coachings and like
right.
Just two coachings and there's no enough answer practice. So
right.
I get
Yeah, so that's a problem that if you don't have right guidance. So maybe if somebody who has cleared with law, if you can connect with that person, he can help you. Because see, ultimately, if you take filtered wisdom, it'll be easier for you to, you know, go ahead with that. And law, especially, I'm not aware of anyone who has, I know commerce and all of these optionals. But I think there's one coaching here, I think, for law.
But they're not taking any answers.
Right.
Schedule
right. So maybe, you know, you should try to find somebody who has probably on Insights on India, you can find some strategy or some topper who has written about law and then, you know, you can connect with that person. Yeah. Yes.
Sir, in the paper on art and culture section, I think while answering the questions, maybe you can give some current aspects also. Like there was a question on 2014, some endless value, somebody
yes.
Connected with smart cities.
Yes.
So you can give some current aspects of like the questions on Gandhara.
Yes. So, yes and no. So point is that it depends on the question. So in the Indus Valley question, it was a very obvious aspect that you can talk about smart cities and like you said, right? So again, that's value addition. If you can do that, if something comes to mind in those 10 minutes, it's well and good. You know, you can write about that. But jaise ab Gandhara art hai, so I personally can't think of anything. So the point is that, and art and culture again, because you know, they are the first two questions. And if you're not able to attempt them well, that becomes problematic. But for that, I think ancient India wali jo old NCRT hai, that is one source, and 11th class ki jo art and culture wali NCRT hai. I mean, these are very good sources because the bend of questions is not exactly cultural, it's socio-economic thoda sa. So, you know, if you read these books, you can place the whole thing in a map again and write accordingly. So,
yes.
Yes, yes. Yes, yes, of course, depending on the space and time you have, yes, you can give those aspects and, you know, how his philosophy is relevant right now or how Ambedkar's philosophy is relevant right now. So, of course, you know, depending on, pehle to aap requirement address kar dijiye question ki, and, you know, then if you have time and space, you can go to the other aspects. Yes, yes. Okay. So science and tech, I have not explicitly prepared anything. I had class notes, which I attended GS class in Rao's IS in 12-13, weekend program. So wahan pe thode bahut notes the. Otherwise, I have not referred to much for science and tech, but I think NCRT's 11-12th is a good source. I think for biology and environment, that comes across. And in science and tech, again, there are a few topics. This is space tech hai, defense tech hai. So, you know, you can, I think Shankar IS ka jo booklet hai, that is also good for science and tech, for mains. Because mains, again, applied questions hote hain. Sometimes they are, this fall out of the sky, allelopathy, right? So, you don't know what to do, right? But theek hai, you can probably, you know, do char aspects hain, which are very important from UPSC point of view, jaise nanotech hai, biotech hai, you know, ISRO's achievements are there, space tech, defense. So, if you are aware of largely, broadly, these aspects, but sometimes, you know, again, those questions are very obscure and there's no good source. Uske liye bhi. So, right, security, again, I referred to booklets. I had a few booklets. And for that, again, the questions will be very applied. But if you are aware of the institutional framework, ki military kaun hai, paramilitary kaun hai, intelligence ka kya framework hai, just be aware of that structure. And the questions, jaise border management pe, ultimately, ghuma phira ke unko wahi puchna padta hai. Because, you know, there's no other question from that angle. So probably there will be a couple of questions from security. But ultimately, it will be more on border management or Maoism. I don't think they've asked yet. So, you know, there are very limited topics there. And there will be one or two questions. So you can refer to one booklet for the static part. And current mein agar kuch chal raha hai, jaise, whether it is chief of defense staff and all of these things are there. So politicization of appointments and all of this. So this is last year these things were in news. So, you know, connect with current and have a static framework to attempt. And for world history, I have referred to NCRT, Arjun Dev wale jo hai. And again, after reading, matlab fourth attempt tak aate aate, main finish kar paya tha wo book is bar. Fir Western Africa ka question aa gaya. So, the point is that it's okay. I mean, ultimately, there is only so much you can humanly do. So, if you can read that book, usme bahut comprehensive hai. If you can read, you know, store and recollect that, wo bahut achha hai. But again, there are multiple sources. They say, what is that Norman Lowy book hai? So I have not seen that, but it's enough, you know, if you do that NCRT, it's enough.
So NCRT,
post-independence, I have personally referred to the Penguin India wali book hai, jo yellow wali, thick book, not all the chapters. Bipin Chandra, yes. So not all the chapters, very few relevant chapters from there. And you know, if you're feeling lazy, I would recommend to watch Pradhan Mantri from ABP News ka ek season hai. So, agar aap wo dekh lo, toh it's enough. You know, you'll get a lot of factual knowledge of things. So you can attempt. Ek do questions aayenge and they'll be very, very general. So nothing to worry. Anything else?
Sir, in paper 2, what was your sketching of introduction? Are you giving reference to constitutional articles? Constitutional framework?
Yes. Yes, I was doing that. I was doing that because ultimately, you know, it is GS2 and you have to show some knowledge of the constitution. But again, don't overdo it. Jaise uniform civil code hai, toh theek hai, article 44. You can put these things, but don't overdo it. And jo major articles hain, all of us are aware of that. The civil servants ke liye article 311 hai, ya election commission hai, amendments hai. So make sure you mention the very basic things. Don't go into too much depth. And again, because requirement of the question address karne mein itna time and space lag jayega ki aapko aas paas ki cheezein thodi kam hi likh paoge aap. But it always helps, I think.
In conclusion, also you are giving reference to constitutional framework in DPSP.
Yes, depends on, again, the question, the requirement. Agar main pehle likh chuka hun, wo, if the question itself is about DPSP, you know, then probably in the conclusion, I can put a way forward ki some of these can be made fundamental rights or whatever, right? Depending on the question, you can attempt.
Sir?
Yes. No, but I referred to that book this time around only. एंड इट्स वेरी ग्राफिकल, बहुत सारे फोटोज़ हैं, सो यू नो आई फील दैट इट इज़ गुड. एंड आर्ट एंड कल्चर उसमें कुछ ऐसे टॉपिक्स हैं विच यू नॉट फाइंड एनीवेयर एल्स, जैसे कैलेंडर्स है, फेस्टिवल्स है, ऑल ऑफ दीज हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स, दीज थिंग्स यू डोंट फाइंड ईजिली. सो आई नो इट्स अ पेन यू नो टू रीड दैट बुक, बट ट्राई टू डू एज मच एज यू कैन, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली एक दो क्वेश्चंस तो आएंगे ही आएंगे, राइट. एंड लाइक आई सेड, बाकी जो दो सोर्सेज हैं, एंशियंट हिस्ट्री, ओल्ड एनसीईआरटी एंड 11th स्टैंडर्ड एनसीईआरटी विच आई रेफर टू, यही तीन सोर्सेज थे मेरे आर्ट एंड कल्चर के लिए. एंड इट टुक मी 4 years टू कम्प्लीट द होल थिंग. Not always. So, for example, Krishnadev Rai, I have written somewhere in my class notes, you know, a few books written by him, or and again, that will depend on आपको कितना याद है, कितनी बार आपने revise किया है, और उस moment पे क्या याद आ जाए. So, again, I didn't attempt that question very well, Krishnadev Rai, but I knew a few books and a few scholars in his court, so I was able to quote that. But again, I'm saying that in GS1 especially, you know, whether it is world history or whether it is culture, इतना vast expanse होता है कि sometimes it can happen, and UPSC likes that, you know, it likes being very unpredictable and torturous. So it's okay, you don't have to pay much attention to those questions. You have to look at the questions which everyone will know, right, and write those well, because ultimately ab Krishnadev Raya hai, it's obscure. Some people would who have history optional might have an advantage, you know, they would know about that. Or social issues mein kuch aisa question aa gaya, sociology optional walon ke liye ya geography mein, to sabke liye you know, you have a different sort of एज होता है सब लोगों को. सो बट इट्स ओके ओवरऑल, इवन इफ लेट्स से GS1 वॉज नॉट अप टू द मार्क, यू स्टिल हैव 6 more papers टू स्कोर, राइट. तो ओवरऑल आपको बहुत अच्छा करना है, एंड प्लीज़ अंडरस्टैंड कि एक दो क्वेश्चन विल नॉट मेक अ डिफरेंस, राइट. सो फॉर एंशियंट, लाइक आई सेड, ओल्ड एनसीईआरटी वॉज माई सोर्स, एंड क्लास नोट्स आई यूज टू रेफर फॉर बोथ मीडियवल एंड एंशियंट. फॉर मॉडर्न आई हैव रेफर टू बिपिन चंद्रा, आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी टाइम्स आई हैव रेड दैट बुक. दिस टाइम आई डेंट रीड इट बिकॉज आई थॉट आई रिमेंबर द होल थिंग, सो आई डेंट रीड दैट. एंड आई रेड स्पेक्ट्रम दिस टाइम बिकॉज दैट्स अ सॉर्ट ऑफ शॉर्ट एंड वर्जन ऑफ बिपिन चंद्रा ओनली. सो फॉर मॉडर्न दैट वॉज द सोर्स. एंड मॉडर्न वॉट एवर, इफ यू लुक एट द क्वेश्चन इन प्रिलिम्स एज वेल एज मेन्स, वेरी वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन, रोल ऑफ वुमेन इन इंडिपेंडेंस, और इवन इन प्रिलिम्स वॉट एवर क्वेश्चन कम, they're very very basic. So for modern you don't need to worry much. Medieval mein of course last time I read a lot of sources, Tamil Nadu book and pata nahi kya kya, and I made notes, and 10 question aaye honge shayad, ek bhi nahi aaya. So again, you know, that there is too much variety in medieval, and because you know the terms sometimes they ask ki ye kya hota hai, and you know it's very difficult to recall at that point of time. If you can, it's good, but अगेन लिमिट योर सोर्सेज, डू नॉट, अगर आपका सब कुछ प्रिपेयर हो गया है, टाइम है, देन यू कैन डिवोट मोर टाइम टू एंशियंट एंड वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज वेरी वास्ट एस्पेक्ट्स. नितिन सिंघानिया, एज आई सेड, यस, सो दैट वॉज अ प्राइम सोर्स. यस, एनीथिंग एल्स? यस, सो गेट योर स्ट्रैटेजी राइट, I would say, and how to get that is, please don't stay in isolation, you know, have a mentor, have a teacher who can guide you. It can be anyone, you know, someone who has cleared the exam with good marks, he can be your mentor. Try reaching out, try seeing what they did right, because ultimately the syllabus looks very sorted and small, but I think more interconnections are needed, like I said. And I think Ansari sir also is a very good, you know, mentor for PubAd. So if you can connect with him, understand and look at toppers answer booklets, that's also one good aspect of this thing, that if you can get hold of something online, how people have written answers, that can help you get a grip on the whole thing. But I am again not the best person to ask, right? Yes.
How you plan for preparation, like giving balance time to optional and
optional? Yes, so like I said, this time I did not balance, it was sort of biased in favor of pol science. But yes, roughly it should be 50-50, because GS mein kya hai ki, even if you're not able to finish a few things, you can write something, right? Because kuch questions bahut applied hote hain, behavioral hote hain, but in the optional, you have to be very specific. So wahan pe to, especially after you take prelims, you got to start focusing on your optional if you have not already read it. So because you have 3 or 4 months before that, so ideally you should be able to prepare it before taking the prelims. But even if after that you're doing it, I think 3 or 4 months is sufficient time. So devote, let's say, half of the day to optional also, right?
Sir,
yes. Right. I think economic survey is enough, because again that will become overkill. It will become very unwieldy for you to read a report or read planning commission document and make notes from it. That will become a pain, right? So jitna data aapko yaad reh sakta hai from economic survey mein jitna hai, right, or budget mein jitna hai, so if you are able to recall that, well and good, because that will be value addition. But even if you are not able to recall facts and figures, it's not much of a problem. Right, so as long as your answer is balanced and complete, that will be fine.
In those questions where we need to put up the previous, do we appreciate the ideas about the job list? So they are asking about our view. So should we take stand in the first line itself or after quoting some data?
No, not in the first line. Of course, in the conclusion you can come at that. And of course, taking a view in this case is, because that is the fact. So view kya hai, wo to hai hai. Right, so that's the point. But you can do it at the end, I think. Anything else? Yes.
So many types of current issues, the daily dialogue of AIR, they are mostly, sometimes they are biased up to government.
Correct.
Sometimes they are not. But if you are in short of content, then it's okay to write their whole dialogue.
Yes, I think so. And in fact, the bias you talk about, that can come in the newspaper also. Because sometimes I think, just say for example, in Indian Express, there is a column which Mr. Chidambaram writes. It's always in criticism of the government, right? So there will always be biases, and you need to filter that out. Ki chalo, you can take that as a con if it is a criticism. You can take that as a con, and jahan pe defense kiya gaya hai, uska that is a pro, right? And ultimately, try to think, try to interconnect. Ki target kya hai? Matlab in ye kya hai? Matlab initiative kya le rahi hai government, and if it is going to lead to results, and then take a balanced view forward. So even for the AIR, I have not personally followed it, but those opinions, do not be very extremist with them. Take them with a pinch of salt and write them as negatives.
So sometimes they go against the government framework,
that is just testing. Right. So again, that is also not very advisable. Sometimes you can. That can fit the requirement. Jaise kuch body, jaise UGC hai, for example. So a committee recommended complete overhaul of the whole thing, right? So that is okay. Ki sometimes if some DRDO hai, it's not performing at all, or Air India hai. So you can suggest privatization or all of this you can do. But again, don't be extremist and try to keep a balanced view of things. And it's okay to alter the status quo. Talk about altering the status quo. That's not much of a problem, I think. Right. So like I said, you have to restrict your sources according to your time. So I think PIB is not very useful, in my personal opinion. So it's very difficult to make notes from that website also, and go back to their monthly, because bahut zyada volume ho jata hai, right? So that is not very useful. Vision IS, like you said, okay if you're referring to that booklet. But again, for the mains perspective, I think that's not enough. So if you're doing Vision IS booklets, try to take a view of things, thoda issue based. Jaise maine Vision IS I have done for prelims mostly, but for mains I have referred to ED booklets, because issue based analysis hota hai. So depending on your time, but don't keep it more than 2. Say Insights on India, I think each month the booklet is 160 pages or something, right? So that becomes difficult to follow through. Agar aapne padh bhi liya ek bar, to aapko revise bhi karna hai, ya fir shayad notes bhi banane hai. So keep that in mind, ki padhna is not difficult, but having that and reproducing that is difficult. So kitna aap ideally kar payenge, keep that in mind, according to me. Anything else? No, they didn't ask me that, because optional is mentioned in the interview, but the last attempt's optional is not there in the DAF. So they only see the current optional which you have, right? So unless you mention it explicitly, they did not ask. And they'll always ask you questions where you will feel cornered and everything. But keep your calm. I think interview ke liye 2 or 3 things which are important is, like for me personally, it was very intimidating the first time I went. I scored only 138 in the interview in the first last year actually. So this time also I've scored only 168. So the point is that it's very unpredictable. Thoda sa, you know, what is the bend of questions, where it is going, you don't know. And try to keep calm because your knowledge level is good enough. And it's very easy to sit across the table and ask a question which you don't know, right? So that's okay. You cannot know everything. But keep calm. Don't let one answer affect your next answer. Agar aap nahi de paye acha answer, to next ke liye normal rahiye bilkul. And sometimes, you know, they start asking technical questions. That depends on your good or bad luck. So, you know, if you have read technical, that is good. Because mostly they ask from graduation or optional subject and current events, especially security, I mean defense sort of aspects and IR sort of aspects. So this is what you need to prepare mostly for the interview. Okay, anything else?
Sir,
yes.
Is there any technical question asked from your tech?
Yes, they asked, last year it was all technical, therefore I was not able to. They asked me about submarine propulsion and everything, so I don't know how I was supposed to know that. And this time around they asked me about my project. So more or less they sort of hate engineers, so they'll ask you something or the other from engineering, right? So have at least look at the subjects which you studied, because I think the first question sir asked me last year was, so what are the subjects you have studied? And I was able to come up with four, where there was 40, right? So please have a view of the syllabus, ek bar dekh lije, go back to that, and bahut basic cheeze hai jo hai, because they ask applied aspects. Just for an electrical engineer, they'll probably ask pankha kaise chalta hai aur tube light kaise chalti hai. So very very applied and practical aspects. For a mechanical engineer, they'll be like ki aap you're going up a hill and your car gets hot, so what will you do? So you know, the daily life things you have to be more aware of. Nitty gritties, technicalities, itna, it's okay. And especially if you have a job, if you have already worked somewhere, they're more likely to ask from that rather than your graduation, right? So plan accordingly. Please study your engineering especially. Okay, yes.
My writing speed is not fast. Like this year, I was able to write only 16 questions in GS. I got 84. So the strategy that you were taking was conclusion.
Right.
So in 4-5 questions, can you do like that 3-4 lines only, and after that, this time?
Yes. So graphical representation always helps, and I feel ki jaise this is one way, like I said, flow chart ho sakta hai, kuch aur ho sakta hai. But ultimately the examiner should not get a feeling ki you are filling up space, diagram bana ke zabardasti, right? So it should be relevant. And whatever you're doing, jaise 3-4 questions mein, if you feel that, you know, you're having less time. But I would suggest you to increase your speed and have more content, because 16 questions, again, you know, even if you miss one or two questions, your chances decline. So jaise you scored 84 for 16 questions, imagine if you had attempted the all of it, so you'd be easily 120, right? Because that is where you have to reach, that is the max. So if you are able to do that, please work on that, right? Okay, anything else?
Which pen you used?
I used Reynolds Trimax because my handwriting comes good from that pen, yes. Anything else? That's it. Okay. Thank you, all of you, for all of your patient hearing, and all the best to all of you. And my blog, I have put up a blog, and there are a few talks there and a few strategies. It's called anandvardhan7.wordpress.com. Anandvardhan 7 is numeric. I'll write it, yes. So this is the blog address. Mostly what I've talked about here, GS4 ke liye, the sources for GS2 and 3, all of this I've highlighted here. There are a few other talks if you have time. I know there's overload of strategy and everything. Every year there are a lot of toppers who talk about it. So, you know, suit yourself. You can visit this. And thank you so much, all of you. And I'll like to connect with you again maybe sometime later. Right now I'm heading home. I need to give some time there. So thank you, all of you.